Hey everyone. Today I have a little makeup haul to show you. It's not really a haul because I didn't buy the stuff for myself, but it's stuff that I got for my birthday, and which was on the 5th. So I'm going to show you what I got and make some. Hope you guys enjoy. So we'll start off with two masks that I got from one of my sisters, and they're both charcoal masks. One, the brand is Yes, Two Tomatoes. And it says it's a charcoal, detoxifying charcoal mud mask with salicylic acid in it. I haven't used it yet. Feels kind of neat. I love charcoal masks, so I'm sure this will be nice. I believe this is a peel-off mask. So yeah, I will be trying this. And I like the shape of this. I know that's kind of strange, but it's like a little teardrop shape or something like that. But I like it. So we'll be trying that soon. Another one I have is Maskology. I guess that's the brand. Never heard of it. It's a charcoal modeling peel-off mask. Okay, so the other one probably wasn't peel-off. The other one was just regular. But this one's a peel-off. It looks like this. And, so yeah, it says detoxifying, pore control, calming, and hydrating. So hopefully this will be nice as well. It says charcoal modeling mask helps detoxify the skin while minimizing the pores. The charcoal powder takes out dirt and debris that can clog pores and make skin look dull and dry, leaving the complexion clarified, refreshed, and hydrated. I'm actually going to bring the camera down just a tad bit because I know that when I lean down to talk into the microphone, my face can't be seen. So hang on just a second. Maybe that'll be good right there, hopefully. But anyway, so those are the two masks that I got. Can't wait to try them. The next thing I got was, let me do my brand, because I got a huge thing from one of my other sisters of Bare Minerals, like this big package of Bare Minerals. I think it was actually supposed to be for Christmas, but it had a lot in it, was my point. So, the next thing I have is a Burt's Bees Gloss Lip Crayon. Never heard of a gloss. I've heard of lip crayons, but I've never heard of a gloss lip crayon. And I actually tried it, and it's really nice. And I love Burt's Bees anyway, so it says Brilliant Crayon, 100% natural. And the color is Bordeaux Vines, 432. There is a pretty good bit of product in here. Let's see. Oh gosh, I'm scared to like roll it all the way out, to be honest. But yeah. Pretty good amount. It's really, it goes on really smooth, and it really is glossy too. Like, it doesn't look glossy in the little applicator, but it is. So, and I love how the little cap has like this, like beehive look to it. Beehive, I don't know what you call that, decoration or beehive, whatever. I don't know. Let's see. Anyway, so I've used it once and I like it. Next, I have, I got a Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Color, and this is a metallic version. I hope you can see this because I'm trying not to look at my viewfinder. So yeah. But let's see, I've tried this once. It's got a really nice scent to it. It smells really good. It is definitely metallic. The matte part of it, not so sure. I mean, it's matte, but metallic is shiny anyway, so it's kind of hard to say it's like actually matte. So I can't wait to try this more often. Because actually, I've got a couple of things from Revlon, and I think it's a pretty good drugstore brand. So the next thing I have, which is really, I'm actually kind of really excited about, is this City Mini Palette from Maybelline. This one is called, oh, you can see all my lights, sorry. Maybe that. Downtown Sunrise is what this one's called. It's got like a really, really light transition shade, a dark brown color, like a medium toned color, and three, like two shimmer colors, and probably like a another, like a highlight or something. I don't know. Intense creamy color for impactful look. Interesting. And I like Maybelline because on the back they tell you where to put the colors, which is nice. Next thing, actually, everything else after that will be from Bare Minerals. I've never used Bare Minerals, so we'll see how they work. I've actually got some lip gloss on right now from them. I love their lip glosses. Love, love, love them. So I got two. Actually, there was actually a bunch more like makeup in this little package that I got, but I gave some of it to my sisters. I've got three younger sisters. So, I don't know. And I gave them stuff that I didn't think I'd wear or that, didn't really, I don't know. I just didn't think either I'd use it or it wouldn't look good on me type of thing. So the first thing I got is this Skin Longevity Vital Power Infusion. Who knows what this is? It's a sample. I think most of these are actually samples, with maybe the exception of the eyeshadows, maybe. I don't know. What is this? It says Empower, Replenish, Renew, Fortify. Powered by Long Life Herb, California Poppy, and Limbuyang Ginger Extracts. Skin Mimetic Technology. I think this is just a, I don't know, something to be good for your skin or something like that. I don't know. Whatever. I tried it the other day just to see, just to make sure it wouldn't irritate my skin or anything like that. And it definitely didn't, so that's good. But it's like a little tiny thing like this. So yeah. We'll see. It has like the lightest scent. We'll see if it works. I don't know. So there's that. There is two, and I believe these are samples, two lip glosses that I got in this golden color that I'm wearing right now. It is in the color Dreamer. I love it. And all of their lip glosses, as far as I know, I've only gotten like three of them, so have like this minty vanilla flavor and scent. And it just makes my lips feel wonderful. Sometimes I put this on at night. I have like a light color, I forget what it's called, but I have a light color that I keep beside my bed, and sometimes I'll put it on before bedtime and wear it throughout the night, and it stays on as long as I don't like rub my face in my pillow or something. It stays on the whole night. So yeah, I got that color, and then I got the color Best Dressed, and it's like this dark ruby color type thing. Let's see, maybe I can. It's like a ruby. Sorry, my nose is itching. Like a ruby colored. I don't know. It's not really ruby. It's like it's not maroon. I don't know what the color this is. Scarlet, maybe? Is that a color? Garnet colored? I don't know. Whatever. It's a dark red color, almost purple. But it's really pretty on the lips as well. I wore it today. And it kind of, what's the word I'm looking for? It kind of, not fades, but melds onto the lips. I don't know, that's not a good word, but it just looks really nice on the lips. I think so. So I got those two colors. Then I got two tiny samples of mascara. They are both Lash Domination. One is, they're both volumizing mascara. One is like a regular sized applicator. And the other one is a petite precision brush, which is super cute. Let's see. So, let me show you the regular sized one. Here's the two bottles. They're pretty small. But that's okay. I've got plenty of samples of mascara that I use. So this one is huge. You see that? It's pretty big. Now compare it to this one, which is pretty small. If I can get it in view. Pretty small. I haven't tried either of them yet, but I will. So I'm sure they'll be good. Okay, so the next things that we have are some samples of lipstick. And two of them I don't like, but I may use them though. I'm not sure yet. So I'm just going to show you. Let's see, this is Baby. This is called Baby. It's like this super light colored. What do you call this? Nude, I guess. It's a nude color. Something like that. The next one is called Rebound. And it's like this dark pink color. Sorry, I'm not a pink person. It's like this. Can you see that? Like a dark pink color. The next one is called Strip. And it's like this dark nude color. Like a dark, kind of like a dark brown color. It looks okay on me. It's kind of nude. Like, it doesn't show up super, you know, super colored or anything. And then that last one is called Elite. And it's like this dark metallic maroony color. It's kind of streaky on my lips because I kind of swatched it. And maybe I just didn't know how to wear it. I don't know. But, anyway. So, that's. And the sizes like this, they're pretty small, but that's okay. I like that kind of thing because I don't use a whole lot of lipstick. I'm trying to use more of that. Okay, let's see. The next things are two Mineral Veils, and I've never used these, don't know how to use them. One is a tinted Mineral Veil and the other one says Original Mineral Veil. I guess you kind of use this as like a foundation powder or something. One's like a dark brown color, the other one's just, I guess you would call it transparent, but I think it's got some shimmer in it or something like that. So this is what they look like. You can kind of see the color difference there. Like a dark color. I've never tried them. I might try them just to see. got those two. And then I've got. Alright, let me get this straight. What is this? Something called an all-over face color. I think that might mean. Because it's pretty dark. I'm thinking, maybe a contour color. And then I have something, let's see, two blushes. One is called Sunkissed and one is called Lovely. I tried to put Lovely on today and it's so pigmented that I had to like take it off basically. It's a little too dark for my skin, but also it was very pigmented and I had to like watch out. So here is the all over face color, possibly a contour color, which I'm gonna try it for that. This is Sunkissed and this is Lovely. Sunkissed is more of like a light pink apricot color, and this other one, Lovely, is like a dark pink color. So that's that. And then I'm gonna see if these are all eye color. Is this an eye color? Eye color. Eye color and eye color. So I have four different eyeshadows. One is called Amazed, and this, so I'll do two at a time. The other one's called Wonderment. Wonderment. They're pretty small, but if they're any, well, when I swatched them on my hand when I first got them, they're really pigmented. I was really surprised. This one, let's see, this one's called Amazed right here. This one's called Wonderment. And then the last two are Wearable Plum Dark and Marvel. And they're, this is the Wearable Plum. Is it gonna focus? Yeah. And this is Marvel right here. But yeah, so I'm pretty excited to use these because when I swatched them, they felt really good. They felt velvety and light on the skin. They were shimmery. They were really pretty. Like I said, a million times, they were super pigmented. So I was very impressed with them. I've never used Bare Minerals, but it kind of makes me like want to try more from them. So yeah, I think I'm gonna add like a little tapping in this video. I hope that's okay with you. I know it's kind of random, but I don't mind random if you guys don't mind random. I wanted to bring back that vase that I had in one video. This one right here. You can see all of the lovely sparkles in it. This is just, it's so mesmerizing, the sparkles are. Whenever I have a bigger house, I say I'm gonna have a bigger house. Our next house, whatever our next house is gonna be. I wanna use it for like decoration because I haven't put it up yet because I wanted to keep using it for videos. So I guess this will be a relatively short video. you guys have had a good weekend. I'm so thankful for this break right now because I just saw a spider. I may have to stop and kill it because I do not like spiders. Anyway, my weekend is not really through yet, thank goodness. Let me just kill this spider real quick because it's gonna bug me if I don't. Is that even what it is? It almost looks like an ant. No, it is an ant. A spider, but whatever. That makes me feel maybe a little better. I don't know. So anyway, what was I talking about? The weekend. I'm off until Tuesday, which is awesome. And then I go back Wednesday. So I'm using this break to get a lot of my work done that I haven't, that I've slacked on in school. But so far everything grade wise is going good, not having any super problems. The only thing that's kind of bugging me is that for Japanese, it's my fifth semester, and in every semester I've made an A in the class, and I've always put work into that class, but this year I'm not able to because I'm taking six classes, and it's just been put on the back burner because I know I'm not going to use it, but I love it so much. Like, I don't care that I'm not going to use it. It doesn't bother me. Like, it's going to be one of my minors. So, anyway, kind of bugs me that I'm not putting all of my effort into it, but at the same time, I have to be realistic with myself, and if that means not putting, you know, as much effort into it, but a little more in the classes that I may actually use, and I mean, honestly, like, going to Japan is not out of the question for my husband, and I would definitely will do that one day. Maybe later than sooner, maybe sooner than later, I don't know. And I honestly even started to consider a study abroad thing with the school. I haven't decided yet if I want to do that, but just, you know, money, time, I wouldn't have a job. So yeah, that would be hard. I mean, I have a job now, so it would be hard to, like, leave a job for even more than 2 weeks. I think that would be really hard to do. So yeah. Decorating for Halloween right now. We live in a subdivision, but we're one of the few people that kind of decorates for, like, the holidays. Like, kind of goes all out to decorate for all the holidays. I'm not sure why, but I don't know. Like, all the kids like our house because we make it kind of scary too, and we try to go all out with the lights and the decorations, and we buy stuff like every year for it to add on to our little collection. We try to increase our collection every year. So, but we love decorating for it, and definitely Halloween is one of our favorite, one of our more favorite holidays. So, honestly, anything where we get to kind of be with each, you know, do stuff with each other is the best, in my opinion. As far as my husband goes. What about you guys? Do you have a favorite holiday? I bet everyone either says Christmas or Halloween. Maybe Thanksgiving. I don't know. I bet it's one of those three, though. But I'd still like to know what your favorite holiday is. Alright, so, I've got a couple of other videos that I want to film. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I try to, like, change up my videos every time. Like, just a different angle, different view, something different. So this one I kind of did, like, an up-close of my face, which is kind of whatever. It's kind of annoying, but just for me, not for you guys. But anyway. So, I hope to see you in my next video. And, yeah. Good night, or day, or evening.